Professor Dave again, let's graph some parabolas.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
Moving on to another conic section, we have the parabola. This is where a plane intersects a cone, going through the edge of the cone and cutting down to the base of that section, rather than across to the other side of the cone, like with circles and ellipses. We learned quite a bit about parabolas earlier, when we first learned how to graph functions, but let's learn the rigid definition. A parabola is the set of all points that are equidistant from a fixed point, called the focus, and a fixed line called the directrix. In other words, any point on this curve will be just as far from the focus as it is from this directrix at its closest point. This is different from something like an ellipse, where it's the sum of the distances from the two foci that remains constant. We also already know that parabolas are second-degree polynomials, but we only looked at very simple examples, like x squared, and others in vertex form that involve only known transformations of x squared. What if we have something trickier, like negative x squared minus 2x plus 1? With this standard form, we can't readily identify shifts or stretches that can be applied to a simpler function. Instead, we can do one of two things. We can either rearrange the equation to get it into vertex form, or we can follow a series of steps that will allow us to figure out where the vertex is and other information that will allow us to graph the function. Let's try the first way first. Remember when we learned how to complete the square? That's exactly what we are going to do here, so that we can get this parabola in vertex form, because once in vertex form, we can just identify all the transformations we need to apply to a simple x squared curve to get this particular parabola. Let's discuss how to do this to a generalized version of a parabola first. Remember from ax squared plus bx plus c, we want to get it into this form, where we have a out here, x minus h inside parentheses, which is then squared, and then k out here. A, h, and k will then represent terms that stretch and shift the parabola so that it's easy to graph. The first thing we need to do to get closer to this form is to factor an a out of the first two terms. For ax squared, we just lose the a, but for bx, we end up with b over a times x. Then we complete the square. Remember, to do that, we take this term here, cut it in half, and then square it. That gives us b squared over 4a squared. We add that inside the parenthetical term, but we must realize that we are really adding a times this term, since a is multiplying across this sum, which means we also have to subtract b squared over 4a elsewhere in the expression, so that we don't change the value of the expression. Then this trinomial is a perfect square, which was the point of all this, so we express it as x plus b over 2a quantity squared. Now, if we express this term as x minus negative b over 2a, we have this precisely in vertex form for a parabola. We have an h and a k, which will allow us to find the vertex, and we have a stretch value over here. Let's take our particular parabola and use the a, b, and c values to evaluate h and k, which will give us negative 1 and 2 as the x and y coordinates of the vertex, respectively. Beyond this, a is negative 1, which means that the parabola opens downwards. And that's how we take a parabola in standard form and put it into vertex form so that it's easy to graph. Of course, we don't have to derive this equation every time. We can just complete the square regularly with numbers. We just factor a out of the first two terms, complete the square, being careful to compensate for this coefficient. Change this to a binomial squared, and there's our equation in vertex form. Now let's try the other way we mentioned, where we leave the equation as it is. The first step in this algorithm will be to figure out whether the parabola opens upwards or downwards. To do this, we look at a and see if it is positive or negative. If the coefficient is positive, it opens up. If negative, it opens down. In this case, we could take the coefficient as being negative 1, so it opens down. The next step is to find the vertex. As we said, this will have an x-coordinate equal to negative b over 2a, which in this case is equal to the negative of negative 2 over 2 times negative 1, which all comes out to negative 1. Once we have that, we can plug it into the function to get the corresponding y-value, which in this case will be 2. This confirms that the vertex is at the point negative 1, 2. From here, we could get additional points by finding the x and y-intercepts. The x-intercepts are the points where the function is equal to 0, so we can find them by setting the function equal to 0. In this particular case, in order to solve this, we have to use the quadratic formula. We went over this in a previous tutorial, which you can check out now in case you forgot how to use this. Otherwise, we just plug in all the coefficients, and when we get the answers, we can just evaluate these to the nearest tenth so that we can get an approximate value to graph. The y-intercept will be much easier to get because that is the value of the function when x equals 0, or the point where the function crosses the y-axis. We plug in 0, and we should get 1. Lastly, we could find the axis of symmetry, which will be x equals negative b over 2a, just to make sure everything looks right. So now we have the vertex, some intercepts, and a line, and that's all we really need to generate a reasonable sketch of this function. We now have a variety of ways to graph parabolas, and not just the easy kind. We can graph parabolas in vertex form by applying transformations, or we can even graph parabolas in standard form by completing the square or finding various points on the curve. Parabolas are tremendously useful in physics because projectile motion always follows parabolic paths. Physics is awesome, though we can't get sidetracked just now as we have one more conic section to go. But first, let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.